Now that we've received our license and our server, it's time to install the software. There are a number of options, but most of them are simple enough once you know what they mean. As before, I'll be stepping through the most common options for a server setup, so please refer to the system guide if you have a different setup. Onboard the disk, there's several installers. Main setup will install the main software, but we also have folders for advanced reporting, if that was purchased. If you're going to install this module, it's generally better to do so first. The OPC UA client allows us to communicate with servers supplying OPC UA data, while the OPC factory server is used to communicate to advanced PLC programs and automatically provide data over OPC. These are more advanced topics, so for now, I'll stick to main setup. First, we'll select the core components to install. The configuration and development environment allows us to develop projects, while the runtime environment runs the projects. There are historical reasons to deselect one or the other, but in our modern server, I'll keep both checked. The deployment architecture allows me to develop a project on one machine and rapidly push it out to multiple servers. If you have a complex server architecture, say a multi-clustered environment, this might help. However, for a single server or even a redundant pair, this often introduces more complexity than it solves. If you have a simple architecture or don't know, leave these unchecked. The Sentinel driver enables the server to access a license key on a USB dongle, while the license manager handles software keys. You can choose which you're going to use, or leave them both checked. Next, there is an add-on to Microsoft Excel to allow you to edit project databases directly. However, this is not supported in Office 2016 and newer, and the functionality is mostly deprecated nowadays, so I will not be installing or demonstrating this feature. The web server for IIS is the legacy web server and not necessary for the HTML5 web client. The profile editor is a critical component in adding devices to a project. The EWS server is used to provide data to other Schneider Electric software packages, and I also have a checkbox to automatically install the OPC factory server mentioned earlier. In short, the default options here are generally correct unless you know otherwise. If your server is configured with multiple disk partitions, you may want to put the data folder on another drive. However, there is no special reason to do this, so I generally leave my paths at the default. Once the installer runs a quick check, I can click through and the software will be installed. This does take some time, about 30 minutes on my machine. Once complete, you'll have a folder on the desktop containing links to most common utilities. As a final note, if there are any other updates or patches to run, now is the time to install those. Next, let's step through the tools and get an idea of how they work together to build a functional project. Until then, thank you.